Food delivery is one of the most commonplace services in the modern world. Combining professionally made food with convenient access from home, food delivery is more popular today than at any other time in history. This is mainly due to modern technology, namely advancements in travel such as the wide distribution of cars and the evolution of communications technology including phones and point-of-sale systems which are commonly used in restaurants all over the industrialized world. In fact, according to Restaurant Business Online, 86% of consumers are using off-premise delivery services at least monthly, showing that delivery services are a staple of the modern food market. Interestingly, food delivery may be enormously popular now, but this idea has existed in rudimentary form for thousands of years, and in this episode, we will take a quick look at the history of food delivery. So, let's get started with the story of food delivery on this episode of How It Came to Be. Believe it or not, historians trace meal delivery services all the way back to ancient Rome around 753 BC to 476 AD. The idea of takeout started back in ancient Rome with the creation of the Thermopolium. A Thermopolium was a place used during the times of ancient Rome where it was possible to purchase ready-to-eat food. They were basically a street kitchen and for those who couldn't afford a kitchen of their own, offering the poor the only opportunity to eat hot food. The food was stored in big clay pots inserted in a counter and probably served in a way similar to modern fast foods. Well-preserved thermopala have been discovered in Pompeii and Herculaneum, and these kitchens demonstrate the beginnings of the takeout concept in the modern food delivery timeline. Historically, if you had access to fresh milk, your family probably owned a dairy cow. But as the United States began to industrialize in 1785, fewer people lived in rural areas. As such, people began to purchase their milk from local dairy farmers. Because milk is perishable and few people had access to refrigeration, daily deliveries were a necessity, and as a result, milk delivery became a standard way of life for many Americans. The first recorded instance of food delivery comes from Italy in 1889. The story goes that on a visit to Naples, King Humberto and Queen Margherita, the King and Queen of Italy, decided to forego their diet of fancy French cuisine and called upon Chef Rafael Esposito to deliver a pizza to them at their palace in Naples. The Chef Rafael Esposito topped the Queen's favorite pizza variety with mozzarella, tomato and basil to represent the national colors of the Italian flag. This was then named the Margherita Pizza. Soon after the first home food delivery in 1889, a man in India named Mahadeo Havaji Butch, in 1890 came up with an idea for a company dedicated to making and delivering home-cooked lunches to workers within the city of Mumbai. This service is known as a Dabbawala, and today there are over 5,000 of them in India, delivering over 200,000 lunches a day to hungry workers all over the country. This intricate meal delivery system is now more modern, and users take advantage of the service using text messaging and email. During World War II, a more modern style of delivery evolved in the UK, where a system was set up for food to be delivered to families that had lost their homes. To ensure the wellness of the British people, the government enlisted chefs and volunteers to deliver meals. The British government provided hot meals to families all around the nation as a way to keep up the country's morale. After the war, this service continued to help veterans get back on their feet. And later this idea was adopted by the private sector in the United States, and the modern takeout delivery service was established. The rise of food delivery in the United States was caused by economic necessity, as during the 1950s, the growing American middle class were content to stay at home watching their new television, and to make their food in their own kitchens. This meant the restaurant industry in the US was starting to collapse. To combat their declining trade, many restaurants introduced carry-out and delivery options and even started advertising their menus on televisions. Newspaper edition from The Times and The New York Times in 1950s stated that restaurants who began providing delivery services boosted their sales up to 50% in a short time and with this simple change, many restaurants were saved. In general, Italian restaurants were particularly well received because World War II troops and post-war tourists had been exposed to Italian cuisine. In response to a deep economic decline in the 1950s, Doris Taylor, member of the Order of the British Empire, sought to help the disadvantaged and homebound by providing hot meals. 11 volunteers delivered the first meals to 8 recipients on August 9, 1954. Over the years, Meals on Wheels has grown to thousands of volunteers, and many countries have duplicated its organizational model. In the United States, for example, there are more than 2.4 million seniors who benefit from the Meals on Wheels service each year. The concept of food trucks began many years ago in 1960s as a way to provide convenient meals and snacks to workers on job sites. Formerly nicknamed roach coaches, these trucks were known for their lack of sanitation standards. However, over the years, food trucks have evolved into a popular way to enjoy restaurant-quality meals in an outdoor setting. In fact, due to much lower startup costs, opening a food truck is an excellent way for aspiring restaurant owners to get started. New players in the meal delivery game are taking convenience a step further by providing logistical services for restaurants. Apps such as Grubhub and Uber Eats allow customers to order from an assortment of local restaurants and, as a result, restaurants that may have previously only offered dine-in or carry-out options can now deliver meals directly to your home or office. Pretty much everyone enjoys a good home-cooked meal. However, due to increased time demands of today's fast-paced culture, home cooking has become a luxury only a few can enjoy. In response, home-delivered meal kits have grown in popularity since the business model was invented in 2007. Companies such as Blue Apron and Marley Spoon allow you to choose a recipe and will deliver pre-portioned ingredients directly to your door. The meals typically take around 30 minutes to make, and allow consumers to save time by eliminating the need to shop. It's estimated that as of 2017, the meal kit industry was worth $2.2 billion. Eating healthy home-cooked food is important to keep our body in prime condition, and so is brushing our teeth with a good remineralizing toothpaste after meals. Do you know when the first remineralizing toothpaste was invented, and by whom? You can check that out and more about the history of toothpaste by visiting the above displayed link. For now, let's resume this video and check the next phase in the history of food delivery. While meal kits initially redefined convenient eating, 30 minutes in the kitchen preparing and cleaning is still a lot of time. The meal delivery service evolved yet again when companies like Factor entered the market, offering fully prepared, home-delivered meals that take 3 minutes or less to prepare. With delivery from such services, people now have convenient, healthy meals delivered straight to your door. The success of all these type of services led to the modern-day food order and delivery systems, where food can be ordered from practically any restaurant with phone apps, computers, or a call. Even during the recent pandemic lockdowns throughout the world, delivery continues to be a staple of the food industry and will continue to be for the foreseeable future. But, what do you think? Did food delivery options have made our life better for good, or are we eating lesser healthy food, and becoming lazy because of them? Let me know by leaving your views in the comment section. If you like this video, let me know by clicking the like button, and if you would like to receive more such videos about how and when different practices, product or services first came into existence, please subscribe to my channel. It's time to end this video. Goodbye, keep safe, and see you all soon with another interesting episode of How It Came to Be.